Hello students, welcome back to the topic sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Students, in the previous video we discussed about cross pollination, whereas in this video we are going to discuss agencies of cross pollination. So as we understood in the previous slide, that is video, students, cross pollination is a process during which pollen grains of one flower will get deposited onto the stigmatic surface of the gynoecium of the other flower produced on the same plant or on the different plant. So the pollen grains are non-motile. They have to depend upon external carriers, agencies for getting transferred from the anther to the stigmatic surface. So which all agencies are there, that we are going to understand. So what happens in cross pollination? Anther is producing pollen grain and pollen grains are non-motile. These non-motile pollen grain have to get transferred onto the stigma. The process is called cross pollination. And pollen grains are non-motile, so they are dependent upon external carriers. So these different external carriers are called agents of pollination or agencies of pollination. Agencies of pollination can be abiotic factors like wind and water, whereas they can be abiotic factors like n number of animals like insects, birds, bats, etc. will bring pollination. So here is a slide, student, with four different types of carriers. Here you can see honeybee is doing the pollination, whereas here it is by bird, whereas this is by snail, and here it is by bat. So let's try to understand agents of pollination. Biotic, in that insects, if they are transferring the pollen grain, then it is called entomophily. Whereas if the pollination is getting done by the birds, then it is called as ornithophily. Whereas this third one is called malacophily, where the snail will be helping in the pollination. And the last one is called chiropterophily. As you can see, bats also help in the process of cross pollination. So there is another type of pollination called myrmecophily, where ants will transfer the pollen grains. So this is a video slide, students, where you can see wind pollination. So anther is getting dehiced, and with the help of wind there is a transfer of the pollen grain. Since the wind becomes a non-living factor, so it is called a biotic. Now here is a Vallisneria plant where the pollination is taking place through the water. It is also an abiotic agent. Now this is a butterfly through insect pollination. It's called entomophily. So it's a biotic type of a pollination. Through birds, just now we understood, it's called ornithophily. It's also a biotic agent. Then through bat is called chiropterophily. This is also a biotic type of a agent which brings a pollination. So here in brief we discussed about different agents of cross pollination, and in the next video we will discuss about abiotic agents of pollination, that is wind pollination. Hope you understood the content of the video, students. Thank you.